So now moving on further, we are done with the NAND gate. Next we talk about the next universal gate, that is the NOR gate. Now NOR actually stands for NOT of OR. So we have an NOR gate and you put in a NOT over here. So this is like so we have an X plus Y coming over here and then inverted, so our output comes out to be X plus Y whole bar. This is how it goes. Okay, simple, straightforward. Alright, so going by the truth table, we have X, Y and the output. So this is like 1, 0, 0 and 0. So again, here the property is any input equals to 1, output equals to 0. You should make note of these properties because these will be using in once we talk about the latches. Okay, so you should remember these properties. Okay, so now, okay, the question comes like why they are actually called the universal gates, because we'll see now by use of these universal gates we can construct the basic gates and not, and once you construct the basic gates you can implement any circuit, all right, using these gates only. Let us see how. Now I'll actually draw parallelly and see how. Now first of all, I want to implement AND gate. Now okay, let me start with first of all, say NOT gate using NAND. Alright, so what do? I like say given this NAND gate, I like short the two inputs. That means I connect both the inputs to the same variable that is coming. So let us see, like, does it work? So what was our truth table for the NAND gate? It was like given X and Y and the output 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. So it was like 0 over here, 1 1 and 1. Now since both the inputs are same, so we have to actually extract out this row and we have to extract out this row. And if I condense, actually what do I get? Given X and what is the output that I am getting from this gate? You can see if 0 is the input, X, 1 is the output, 1 is the input, the same as the truth table of the NOT gate. So that means if I short the two inputs of the NAND gate, it behaves like a NOT gate or the inverter. So essentially using the NAND gate, I have been able to implement the NOT gate. Clear? Okay. Now, next step is actually, I want to implement AND gate using NAND. Okay, what do? I implement this circuit in this way. First of all, I generate a NAND and then I put a inverter in front of these two. Alright, so let us see, does it work in the same way? Because like you have to be like satisfied with the fact that if the truth table of two gates or output of two gates are giving the same output in the truth table, same values. So those two gates are implementing the same function. Okay, it is impossible, like if two gates are giving same output and they are performing differently, impossible. Those two gates are equivalent because then only they are giving the same output. One circuit may I have like be implementing using tens of gates or hundreds of gates, and like if circuit one circuit I implement using two or three gates, if they are giving the same output, so they are the same gates. Okay, so like implementing over here, I call this over here intermediate output is OP1. Okay, and then OP. So this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, and 1, 1. So what is OP1? So by the truth table of NAND gate we had seen earlier. So this is 1, 1, 1, and 0. Alright. And now we have earlier seen, if you short the two inputs of a NAND gate, so it becomes a NOT gate. So this 1 becomes a 0, this 0, 0 and 1. This was same as the truth table of our AND gate, the output we get over here. So actually we can see that this circuit is behaving like a 2 input AND gate. Alright. Now, if I am to generate the OR gate, so I construct my circuit something like this. So let us again try to see, is it giving me the same value as the OR gate? Then only the circuit will be same, otherwise not. Okay, so this is like, this output will be say X bar, this is like Y bar, outputs of NOT gates, so they are written in that way. So again by the truth table we have say like X and Y, X bar, Y bar, and what will be the output. So like 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Okay, so X bar is the complement of these values 1, 1, 0 and 0. This is 1, 0, 1 and 0. Now these are going as, okay, I also number these gates 1, 2 and 3. So the output of gates 1 and 2 are X bar and Y bar respectively. Of the gate 3, the inputs are X bar and Y bar now, and I want to construct the output. So with these two as the inputs, 1 and 1, output will be 1.1, that is 1, and complement of that, so that is 0. This is 1, 1, and 1. Alright. This is the same as the output of the OR gate. So we are like convinced using the NAND gate, we have been able to design. This is like same as 2 input OR gate. So we have been able to construct all the 3 basic gates. And as I told you, any circuit is constructed using these 3 gates only. And OR and NOT. So if you can construct, or you have actually been able to construct AND, OR and NOT using one of the universal gate, we'll see other also like NOR construction also. And if in a circuit you can replace these all the gates by using NAND gate, so you've been able to draw the circuit using NAND gates only. So this is, that is why called the universal gate. Alright, let us see the NOR treatment also. NOT gate using NOR. Again, I have X. Now the two inputs I short together. So again, the similar approach, our truth table for NOR gate was Oh, this was 1, okay, 0, 0. So again, I have to extract these two rows because the two inputs are. So again, you can see, given 0, we are getting 1 as the output, 1 and 0, this is behaving like a NOT gate. Now, I have to implement AND gate using NOR. So this is a like kind of, you can say like this goes this way, the similar approach. Now this will like come over here, and this we'll see over here. That will be case number 3 or gate using NOR. So AND using NOR, now it will go like this. You can convince yourself, okay, by proving through truth table, it will behave exactly as the AND gate. Now using the OR gate, this will be now X and Y. So whatever the output I get, I short the two and this is the output. So why like I put in like this, because you can say the similar construction. One gate you short the two inputs, one gate you short the two inputs. Over here like three gates involving. The similar way, first gate you short the two inputs, first two gates rather, one and two, I'll again put the numbers. So you're actually shorting, and then third you feed the input. Over here you have two gates, one the output of the first gate, then second input, input to the second gate, you're shorting again. The similar construction. Got it. Say for example, okay, just to give you another concept, is what we something called are the bubbled input gates. Bubble input gates simply mean that before giving the input, you are actually complementing the input. That means giving the value instead of X, you are giving X bar. Say for example, you have X, Y, you put in a NOT over here. So only thing is that instead of giving the input as X and Y, you are giving X bar and Y bar. Alright. So this is called our bubbled input AND gate. Like, what is the importance of these two? Let us see. Now, the input actually to the gates we have 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. Now, I have actually inputs X bar and Y bar. Now I have to perform the AND of these two. 1 and 1 output is 1, 1 and 0 this is 0, 0 and 0. So what do I see? Which gate we have done it previously? This is a NOR gate. So actually my bubbled input AND gate behaves like a NOR gate. Alright. Next we talk about the bubbled input OR gate. That is, we have say X and Y, then x bar and y bar, and then the output. So again 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. So x bar is 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 0. Now you perform the OR. 1 plus 1 1 1 1 and 0. Now this is same as our NAND gate. Alright. So this is the concept that bubbled input OR gate is same as the NAND gate, and bubbled input AND gate is same as the NOR gate. Alright. Okay. Like why I am actually performing this, you will come to know and will tell why. How? So just to give you another concept, if say suppose you have a gate, some variable input x going as input to the NOT gate, and then I again put the NOT gate over here. What do we actually arrive at? Let us see. You have say OP1 coming over here, so you have x, you have OP1 and then OP 0 1, so 1 0, now again 0 and 1. Actually you can see that these two agree. That means in a NOT gate, if you complement it more than once, or sorry, rather even number of times, over here I have completed 2. So x put in one NOT gate, you get complemented output, you again complement, you get a variable back or x value back. So that is the simple concept. Okay, so now why actually we did all those things, we'll just see how. That is actually a very simple concept in terms of the circuit design. Alright. So let us take for example, we are given circuit. Given some circuit, we have like output as x bar y plus say, okay, we start with some small, very small values, just combination 2 to 8, can 3 or 4 also. Details will come to this when we deal in Boolean algebra, SOP and POS, sum of product, product of sum. Okay, so like if we have to implement this circuit, I have to design a circuit using basic gates. If I say have x bar, so I have to generate a x bar, so I put in a NOT gate. Okay, then I have to AND it with y, so I have to put in a AND gate. Alright, then I have a yz coming in, so I take this y from here and I have a z coming over here, and I have to perform an OR operation, okay, of these two. So my output will be generated. Alright. Simple, straightforward approach. I number these gates as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now what do I do? I'll just now design this circuit using NAND gates only. Only NAND gates. And this I can easily do. Okay. Because of all those things we have seen right now. Okay. Okay, you can actually design, you can replace the OR gate by the 3 NAND gates, and you can replace by the gates 2. Okay, so actually if we take, so gate number 1 will replace by one NAND gate. Gate 2 I will have to replace by 2 NAND gates. Okay, gate 3 again I have to replace by 2 NAND gates. And gate number 4 I have to replace by 3 NAND gates. And I am sure our circuit will be designed. Okay. But I'll give you certain different way. Why? Because each and every gate that is added to our circuit, it is disastrous in terms of two things. First of all, the cost required to design the circuit is increasing, and for each and every added gate, the propagation delay is adding. Propagation delay means like you give the input and the time in which the output is available. Propagation delay is increasing and the heating and other things are also increasing. With each and every gate that you add, it will have some circuit, so heating and other things increase. What do I do? I will design this circuit. This I will take, so like if you sum this all, I actually require 3 plus 2 5 plus 2 7 and 1 8 9 gates. Okay, but I will design this circuit using 4 NAND gates only, the half of this. How? Let us see. Gate number 1, I start designing now. Gate number 1, I'll use the same approach that we have done before, and the signal Y goes in over here and the signal Z. Now this is a AND gate. Now instead of gate 1, I put in 1, so 1 dash I call it that way. 2 and 3 actually I have over here. Alright. So 2 I actually replace by 2 dash and 3 by 3 dash. Why? Like I put in a NOT in front of these two. So these become the NAND gates. But you'll say, sir, the output is not consistent. So what do I do to keep the circuit same? I'll NOT it again before feeding. Because we had seen, like, if you complement 2 times or even number of times, you get the variable back. So 1, and before feeding I complement again, so 2 times I've complemented, it remains unchanged. Now this becomes what? Gate number 4 dash becomes what? Bubbled input OR gate. And the same as our NAND gate. So what do? I replace it by a NAND gate and my circuit remains unchanged. So in short, I have been able to design my circuit using NAND gates only. We will talk in detail about this when we cover the Boolean algebra and sum of product and product of sum, SOPPOS. Okay, we will return to this. So right now actually you can see the power of the universal gates, why they are called so, and like how easily we can design the circuits. Alright.